we interact with everyday things. What are all these people doing? They are all measuring something. We normally ask, how much it weighs? How high is it? How much volume it occupies? How fast the vehicle is moving? And so on. As you know, ice is cold and steam is hot. Hot and cold are relative terms. These terms do not give us any concrete information about its temperature. We want to measure, refer, and compare things quantitatively. We are talking about physical quantities like mass, length, temperature, time, and many more. These enable us to understand nature much more accurately than describing it qualitatively. A physical quantity is a property of a material that can be quantified by measurement. Physical quantity can be defined by specifying how it is measured. There are other physical quantities which can be calculated from other quantities. We define distance and time by specifying methods of their measurement. How about speed? How speed is calculated? When we define speed, we specify that it should be calculated by dividing the distance travelled by the time taken for the same. Measurements of physical quantities are expressed in terms of units, which are standardized values. Distance covered for a marathon is measured in kilometers. Distance for the fast sprint is measured in meters. Without the units, it will be difficult to compare values in meaningful ways. Many laws of physics are defined using these properties. It is important that these properties must be measured accurately. This is essential because all measurements are ultimately expressed in terms of fundamental units and can be no more accurate than are the fundamental units themselves. There can be more than one way to measure the fundamental property. Length is the most important measurement in everyday life. In olden days, inch was thumb and foot was foot. The word mile in Roman is milla passus, means 1,000 paces, approximating to mile. Body parts were used for measuring length. For measurement of weight, human body provides no such approximations as for length. So, grains of wheat was used as reference. Goat skins, baskets, jars provided rough measure for measurement of volume. Though days, months, and years could be measured with sun, stars, and galaxies, hours, minutes, and seconds were hard to measure accurately. People relied on sundials, water clocks, and sand for time measurements. These units of measurements, though worked locally, were not very useful across cultures. Scientists decided to define one standard for all the physical quantities. There were many systems used for units like English, American, and SI systems. Nowadays, scientists and mathematicians use SI units. The acronym SI is derived from the French Système International. Length, mass, time, and electric current are the most fundamental physical quantities. Length is measured in meter. Mass is measured in kilograms. Time is measured in second, and electric current in ampere. This is a metal cube. How will you measure its size? It has length, width, and height. Though we use this differently for our convenience, they are the same thing. When we are measuring length, width, or height, we are basically measuring distance between the two points or length between the two points. These units are part of the metric system, which uses powers of 10 to relate quantities. This allows us to measure the vast ranges encountered in nature, like millimeter to measure small distances and light year to measure very huge distances. We measure football ground by area and amount of water this container has by volume. These are based on a basic physical quantity, length. Area of a rectangle is measured as length multiplied by breadth, while volume of the cube is calculated as length multiplied by breadth multiplied by height. Area and volume are derived quantities. They are calculated from basic physical quantity, length. SI unit for the time is second, abbreviated as S. For a long time, it was measured as 86,400th part of mean solar day. But scientists found out that this was getting longer due to gradual slowing down of Earth's rotation. As a result, scientists shifted to another method. Cesium atoms can be made to vibrate in a very steady way, and these vibrations can be readily observed and counted. Similarly, meter was also defined as distance between two engraved lines on platinum iridium bar. Later, it was redefined to be measured in terms of wavelength of light. Initially, gram was the fundamental unit of mass. It was considered too small, hence kilogram was introduced. The kilogram was originally defined as the mass of 1 liter, that is 1000 cubic centimeters of pure liquid water at 0 degrees Celsius. But later on, scientists decided to refer to standard machined block of platinum iridium as 1 kilogram. As of 2019, SI system has base unit definitions on physical constants with fixed numerical values and on other base units. This rod is 1 meter long. Here, we are talking about physical quantity, length. 1 is the value and meter is the unit used to express the magnitude or amount of this physical quantity. We discussed about physical quantities such as mass, length, and time. There are physical quantities like speed, which are based on these fundamental quantities.